Hello everyone, welcome to the CTV News on Calabash TV and on the Wave Radio 94.5. I am Alyssa Joseph. 72 hours after the nation was told that Senusha will not follow through with its bid to host the 2017 Commonwealth Youth Games, the head of the local organizing committee convened a press conference to discuss the factors that led to that decision. Richard Peterkin said going into the bidding process and subsequent preparations, money was always a central consideration. In his brief address to the nation Tuesday, Prime Minister Dr. Kenny Anthony informed that the price tag of hosting the games was too hefty for the country at this time. Further, the George Odlum National Stadium would remain out of commission perhaps for the better part of 2016 and would require some $15 million to renovate. While staring clear from stating that Senusha missed out on a golden opportunity to invest in new developments that could have eventually generated revenue, Richard Peterkin said there could have been a legacy with a difference.
There's always an issue, as we knew, with the availability of revenue in the sense of the identification of funds for the budget that we had proposed, and also the inability to find a project, which is what I had hoped would be the real legacy of building a dedicated athletes village, which would then be sold as housing afterwards. Unfortunately, after looking at many locations, we then decided that it would be best to have it down close to George Odlum because of the flat land that's there. Very difficult to find private investors who would have been prepared to do, to borrow the money and do the development. And as it turns out, because George Odlum was not available, maybe that's all worked out for the best in that regard. Lessons learned. One of the things that we learn from these things is that we need to distinguish between the operating cost of hosting our games and the infrastructure cost. And we know of that in the Olympic Games and any other games. The operating cost is really the cost of actually running the games and the transport and the logistics and everything else. The infrastructure is generally the cost of building stadia and building roads and rebuilding airports and other things that governments undertake if they are supporting a bid for a games.
Hosting the Commonwealth Youth Games would have required some $34 million, according to the Prime Minister, but the LOC chairman says that price tag was not necessarily for the operation of the games. Already there was little infrastructure cost for Senusha. The new National Aquatic Center is being funded by the government of Taiwan to the tune of $12 million.
It would have been nice if you had an indoor facility to help in netball. It would have been nice, if we were able to maybe build another track. But at the end of the day, we didn't need those things. We did not even need a 50-meter aquatic center. We could have had swimming in a 25-meter pool. And all of this we told the government. So our core operating cost was really not the $34 million that the Prime Minister referred to. That figure included the cost of the pool and the cost of rehabilitating George Odlum. So I want to make sure that the public knows that we weren't trying to burden this country with a huge amount of expenditure. The pool and George Odlum are things that the government, pool certainly has been something on the books for a long time. George Odlum is something they have no other choice. They have to do it. And that's nothing to do with our games.
And despite the belief that the withdrawal has caused international embarrassment, Richard Peterkin says St. Lucia is not the first country to go that route.
City of Halifax withdrew from a bid for the 2014 Commonwealth Games. City of Edmonton withdrew from the bid for the 2022 Commonwealth Games. Cities of Oslo, Krakow, Lviv and Stockholm all withdrew from the bids for the 2022 Winter Olympic Games. Boston, as you would know, withdrew from the bid for the 2024 Winter Olympic Games. Guadalajara withdrew as the host for the FINA World Champs for 2017. And recently Vietnam, the host for the 2019 Asian Games, had to withdraw. In almost every instance, the withdrawal was due to financial issues. In some cases, maybe in the case of Ukraine, it was because of the unrest there. But Boston, for example, Edmonton, all found that when the cost of the games started to increase and they realized it had to be funded out of taxpayers' money, they knew that it was not going to be a possibility and they bailed. I'm glad to see that LA has now agreed, notwithstanding that, that they are going to support and guarantee the finances, so LA is bidding for the 2024 Summer Olympic Games. But all of these happened after 2008, and it shows you the impact that the global recession has had, particularly where people are concerned about the cost and passing that on to taxpayers. So we
about 1,000 athletes from 71 countries and territories were expected to compete in St. Lucia in what would have been the biggest event to be held in the Caribbean since Jamaica hosted the 1966 Commonwealth Games.